that's the word that came into my mind, that came into my heart to talk about for him, because he is visionary.
I think the thing I admire most about him and his business is just his tenacity and his grit. And part of that, I think, comes from, and I'm a little biased in this, growing up in East County and growing up out in the Park Rose area, and because that's where I'm from. Not a lot of people these days own that. It really is a place that needs that.
To be able to speak up in that way, that says something about somebody's character, about who he is. And I know that comes from where he was raised, who he was raised by.
Alando has been called a change maker, and Portland needs more people making the kinds of changes Alando has made.
So he is a second generation in this business. He's taken it over from his father, who really set him up for success, but he's taking it under his own terms to the next level.
We're in Portland. We recycle everything here, right? We recycle everything. And for him, his family, to have that vision that this is something that we need to get on. We need to get in on this and to push their way in. That's visionary in itself.
And I know he wants to be the first disposal and recycling company with all electric garbage truck fleet. And so they don't even have that many manufacturers making electric garbage trucks, and he's already thinking ahead.
At a time when our climate crisis is having a direct impact on our day-to-day lives, this is exactly the kind of innovation we desperately need.
He's done a lot in his short adult life that sets him up to be a long-term leader in Oregon. And he will be a long-term leader, both in business and in the community and in the state.
He was that as a kid, and he's that as a man. He's someone that if he believes in something, he's gonna say it, and he does not make excuses for it.
He's a very visionary advocate for economic progress as a means of making social progress.
One thing that's really special is his leadership in this Black Economic Prosperity Initiative.
We haven't decided if it's BEPA or BEPA. We haven't decided, but it's Black Economic Prosperity Alliance. This was born out of the Portland Business Alliance during Freedom Summer. So Alando reached out to me and was like, okay, we need to get on the same page. Our time is now. Action time is now. So let's just get in a room and just talk about it. Let's get everybody in the room and just talk about it and find out, you know, what the differences were, and let's move past that, because it's bigger than that. It's bigger than that. And that's what I really like about Doe, is that he is like, I don't care about all that. It's bigger than that. Put all that aside. How are we gonna make this work so everybody eats? Everybody eats, and our kids eat, and their kids. And so that's what sets him apart, I think. That's what makes him different. You know, he can be a connector, and that's important.
He's very good at connecting with people of diverse perspectives and experiences. And that's a real skill.
Alando is unquestionably committed to his community. He's invested a significant portion of his life to equity.
He holds himself to a certain standard. He holds himself to being a man of integrity, a man of purpose.
You come from a strong family. You come from a family that instilled some great values in you of doing the right thing, not just for yourself and your workers and but for your community as well.
It gives me great hope to know that we have community members like Alando to help with these efforts.
And being able to see him just grow into who he is. And he's still growing. He's still growing and still has many more things to accomplish. I know he's not done. He's not done at all.
You know, go Park Rose Broncos. I had to get the Broncos in there. Come on.